All right. Well, what's up, everybody? GrimmGreen back here today. Thank you so much for joining me. Ald Amaze. The company that makes this is Ald Amaze. So, as I've said before in lots of other videos, I'm a pretty big fan of pod systems, and I'm a pretty big fan of these, like, sort of new medium size pod systems. I almost want to call them large size pod systems, because your average pod here, let me grab this. This is that KWIT stick. This is like the size of an average pod system, right? And so then you have these guys. And I feel like these are like the large version of pod systems. They're a little bit bigger. Things like that Inokin EQ, things like, you know, like the Sauron Air or the Sauron Drop, like bigger sized pod systems. And I'm a pretty big fan of them. And this Ald Amaze is called the Lemon. And from what I could tell, Ald Amaze has been around for a little bit now. And they've done a few things in the cannabis industry, and they've done a few things in the vapor industry as well. They had another product in the vapor industry that was a similar-ish pod system called the Mango, and then they released this. It's called the Lemon. Interesting, I guess. I mean, maybe that's just the way they name stuff. The Ald Amaze Mango, the Ald Amaze Lemon, the Ald Amaze, you know, grapefruit. So, with all that said, this is the Ald Amaze Lemon, and it is a little bit, I'm calling it a large pod system. That's the only way that I can, you know, logically think about these, and it's called the Lemon. It's got a big, like, 500 milliamp hour, I believe it's actually, like, 520 ma or milliamp hours. It has a 3 mil capacity tank, and it uses dual ceramic heating elements on the inside, which translates into a real nice, smooth mouth to lung experience. One thing that I've noticed when using this particular Ald Amaze pod with the dual ceramic in there is I don't ever get any dry hits at all. Ever. Every toot that I take off of this feels nice and saturated. And, you know, there's some pod systems out there, you know, like we were talking about last week, where it feels like it's just on the verge of being dry. That's an annoying thing in pod systems that I've come across a lot lately, and I don't get that at all from this Lemon pod. Now, I'm not using salt nicks in here because I'm generally just not a big fan of salt nicks. They don't sit right with me, and I don't like vaping them. So this is filled up with just a regular freebase nicotine 50/50 PGVG. Really, really enjoyed the vape quality that I get from this particular pod. And it all fits together just with magnets. It could not be simpler. You have this big battery. You have this large sized battery right here with a little LED indicator on there. And every time you drop your pod in, it shows you, it's going to light up real quickly, like how full your battery is. And you can see I've been using this for a while. When I drop this in here, that battery level indicator is basically dead. It's on like the last little light down here. And when it's fully charged, obviously you're going to drop the pod in and it's going to light up all the way to the top and it'll slowly go down. Little battery level indicator. Really nice. Really handy to have on a pod system like this. The pod itself always stays incredibly, incredibly clean, and it's incredibly easy to fill up. On the bottom of the pod right here, you have the magnets that are going to connect to the inside. Then you have this little door, and you just kind of put your fingernail under here, and you have this little flip-top door, and it's got a nice big opening right there for you to just dump your juice in there. And I've used, you know, Chubby Gorilla pointy tip bottles. I've used glass dripper bottles, and I use, like, even those plastics stubby tipped bottles. No issues filling this at all. It's a nice big wide opening there to fill it up. And then after you fill it up, literally all you do is you just close this little trap door. There's a little O-ring on there. Boom, kind of like very slightly clicks into place, and it stays closed. And then, like I said before, you kind of just pop, just drop it in there. It just falls right in there. And this is only held in by magnets, which is one of the things that kind of honestly bums me out about this. The magnets are not very strong. They just kind of hold it in enough just to hold it in. It doesn't feel like a very secure thing. I would love for these bigger pod systems like this to have some sort of like click, like a little bit more click, a little bit more. I can't even think of the word that I want to say right now. I just wish the pods held in a little bit more securely. As it stands, there's a little bit of like play back and forth. When I drop this pod in here, I can move the pod around back and forth and it kind of wobbles. I can feel it hitting both sides of the battery compartment. And if you're holding it by the pod, and even if you give it a quick little like boops, yeah, it just falls off every single time. And if this is something that's like in your side pocket or in your back pocket and you grab it and you grab the pod, you will just be pulling the pod out of your pocket. I really feel like with the weight, especially with the weight of this battery is weighty. It feels like it's made out of zinc. Like it's a real weighty feel to it. And those magnets, they just don't hold on there very well. If you're aware of it, you can, you know, avoid having this, you know, constantly fall out or accidentally constantly pulling this out. I'm repeating myself. I wish it clicked and I wish it was a little bit more secure. One thing you cannot complain about this is just the feel of it. In your hand. Just feels like a nice little smooth little weighty object in your hand. It's real easy to just kind of hide it, kind of hold it in your hand like this. You have a little mouthpiece right here that's real sort of like slender and very comfortable to hold. The airflow on it is real smooth, but it's not real tight. And I know that's a thing that people get real concerned about with their mouth to lungs. They want it to be just real, like a real tight airflow. That is not the case with this Ald Amaze Lemon. I genuinely feel like it's kind of a perfect mouth to lung airflow, but I like my mouth to lung airflow just a little bit. Not completely open, but just a little bit more open. Make it a little bit more swooshy. And that's what I get from this. And it's rocking. It's a rocking vape. It's a real nice performer. It produces a lot of vapor. The flavor is where this thing kind of falls a little bit short for me. I don't love the flavor that I'm getting out of these dual ceramic coils. I don't know what it is with ceramic, but it never seems to deliver the flavor that I want. This is Strawberry Circus. This is a juice that I have been vaping since 2012. I'm very intensely familiar with the way this juice is supposed to taste, and this particular pod, this particular dual ceramic coil that is in this lemon isn't quite giving me that flavor that I'm used to. I can still taste it, you know what I mean? I can still tell that it's Strawberry Circus. I know what juice I put in here. It's just that flavor level feels, it just feels real lacking to me, which is kind of honestly a real big shame because I really like the feel of this vape. It feels real nice. The airflow feels real nice and I get a good amount of satisfying vapor from it. I just feel like the flavor is not really there on this. No complaints at all about the battery life. You know, you're using a 1.8 ohm dual ceramic coil in here, so you're not going to be plowing through your battery life. 520 mAh is a nice long battery life. The 3 mil capacity on this, fantastic. You're not filling it up as much as you would like a sub-ohm tank or anything like that. You're not really plowing through juice. So this is one of those things with a full tank and a full battery, I could take this and leave the house and just be gone all day long and I wouldn't be worried about my battery life and I definitely wouldn't be worried about my juice consumption. So really, let's get down to brass tacks here. Would you need your vape budget hands if you wanted to try to buy the Ald Amaze Lemon? I don't know, but I don't think so. The only place that I could find a price for this exact device was on Alibaba, and their recommended MSRP for it is between $19 and $25. I haven't been able to find this on any other vendors' websites. I couldn't find it on Vapor DNA. I couldn't find it on Element Vape. I couldn't find it on my Vapor store. I couldn't really find it anywhere. So I'm 100% not sure of what the price is, but if they go by the suggested price, $20 to $25, yeah, I mean, that's no real vape budget hands territory. That falls into the category of it's almost cheap enough just to buy it, just to try it out. Now, if we're gonna play the aliens game or the FDA game where they come and take everything I have, and I have nothing left to vape, is the Ald Amaze Lemon Pod System, something I would seek out and buy right away. There would have to be some improvements made to this before I would want to buy it. A, I'm going to need some better flavor. I don't know what we can do about that. It uses those dual ceramic coil heads. Maybe that's where the issue is, but to me, I would need much better flavor out of this. And two, I would need this pod to really feel much more secure. It needs to click or have stronger magnets or something. As it stands, I mean, the battery just releases itself from the pod constantly. It doesn't feel very strong, it doesn't feel very secure, and that kind of is overall what bums me out most about this. But otherwise, it's honestly a pretty rad vape. I would vape it right now, but my battery is completely dead. I really should have charged this before I even started shooting any video. That's my bad. That's gonna be my bad right there. And I'm going to stop rambling, so thank you so much for watching, everybody. That's what I got for today. And as I always say, YouTube really dislikes links to external vape shops in the description of the videos, and I don't like getting my videos flagged, so you're gonna have to use your Google Foo, but it is spelled Ald Amaze, Aldamaze. It's the lemon. You can go use your Google Foo. Okay, finally, lastly, thank you so much for watching, and as always, I have a dead battery, but you should keep on vaping.